So, there's this buzz going around about the Google Helpful Content Update that has content creators and blog site owners freaking out. And it has tech nerds like me geeking out. And the Google searchers, well, they're none the wiser. They haven't noticed any change. See, AI isn't just writing, it's researching, it's learning, and it never runs out of topics to blog about. Now, while this is the dream tool for some, it's an absolute business crusher for others. In today's video, I'm going to show you how I wrote an autonomous AI agent that can research using Google, learn, and write a blog post on any topic. Now, stay to the end to watch it in action, but for now, let's dive in. All right, now before we dive into the code line by line, I want to go over a high level overview of what we're going to be doing. So basically, we're going to be setting up two agents. We're going to have one agent that searches with Google, and we're going to have a second agent that actually writes the blog post from the information that we got from Google. Now, let's dive into the code line by line. First, we're just going to look for our command line arguments. We're just going to be looking for our topic that we're going to research. Next, we're going to load our environment file, which is going to contain our API keys. So I have my OpenAI API key, as well as my Google API keys for the Google Search API wrapper. Next here, I just have a simple function that just checks to see if our blog post is finished. If we see finished chain in the output, or if the output length is over 1500 characters, we're going to say that it's complete. And why 1500 characters? That's because that's when we're going to start running into context issues when we hit that OpenAI API. Here we're just loading our Google API keys, and this first research LLM is going to be TextDaVinci 003, and it's going to be temperature of 0, and we're just going to keep for both true so we can see the output as it generates. Next, we're just going to initialize our Google Search API wrapper. And we're going to set our tool dictionary. We're just going to call the tool Google Search, a description as useful for research when you need to ask a search, search Google for recent results. And the function is just search.run. And again, this is standard with Langchain. So you get all this out of the box with Langchain. And next, we're going to want some memory. So we're just going to use the conversation buffer memory here. And this will be useful when our autonomous agent is running multiple prompts. And next, we're going to initialize our search agent. So we're going to give it the tools. We're going to give it that research LLM, which is that TextDaVinci model. It's going to be a zero-shot React description. So that means it's going to have a reasoning step before it reacts. And this agent type is specific to our model. So this is for a text generation TextDaVinci model, not a chat model. And we're just going to say verbose true so that we can see the output as it generates. We'll give it the memory and we'll tell it to handle any parsing errors for us. The next thing we're going to do is set up our second agent. And remember, this is the one that's writing the blog post. So this one, we're going to use the chat model, which will be GPT-4. Again, temperature of 0 because we don't want it to make anything up. And we'll just say verbose true because, again, we want it to log as it's running. And again, we'll set up our blog post writer agent. And this one is pretty much the same, except it's going to use the conversational React description. And this is because we're using a chat model and not a text generation model, not the TextDaVinci model, but GPT-4. And here we're just going to execute our first agent, which is the search agent. We're going to tell it to run and we're going to store the results in search results. And then we're going to have our prompt for the blog post. The first prompt is going to be write a 1,000-word blog post reacting to the following information, and we're going to feed it those search results. And then when you're done writing, put finish chain at the end. And then here is our loop. Basically, we're going to create an empty blog post. Our current input is that simple prompt we just made. And then while our output's not complete, we're going to run our second agent. And we're going to take those results and add it to the blog post. And then if it's complete, we'll break out of the loop. If it's not, we'll do our next prompt, which is continue writing the blog post from the last sentence We'll feed it the blog post that it's currently been making. When you're done, put finish chain at the end, and then we'll print out the results. All right, so here we go. Let's give it a test. All right, so I'm gonna open up my terminal here and I'm gonna make it nice and big for you guys. And what we're going to do is we're going to run the code. And basically I'm just doing a very long prompt here to get my conda environment, make sure it's right. And I'm gonna tell it, research an article by The Verge called People Who Ruin the Internet. And basically this article was written only a few days ago, so there's no way that ChatGPT would know about it. And I'll hit enter here and we'll see that it starts to execute. So there you go, it's searching Google, it's got the information, and now it's going to start writing the blog post. And this chain is going to execute a few different prompts. It's going to continue to execute while it's doing that loop. And at the end, we'll get a finished blog post complete from the information that was returned here in these search results. All right, so it's finished and here we go. It has a title for the blog post, The Internet, a tool for empowerment or exploitation. And basically it gives us a 1000 word blog post. We have finished chain here at the end, so that's how we knew it was complete. And it's using information from Google to do all of this. And there you have it. That's how you can build your own autonomous AI agent that can literally research 24/7, learn from its research, and then write a blog post on just about any topic that you can come up with. Now, if you like the content in this video, please go ahead and click the like and subscribe button, or leave a comment. And with that, I'll see you in the next video.